Rhode Show, this morning in the buzz, we are talking Easter celebrations for many people. For many Christians, it's the marking the holiday this Sunday. And for from morning church to brunch to our favorite candy and egg hunts, there are many traditions to look forward to. So we wanted to know, what are some of your favorite things to do? What are you doing?
We are having brunch.
Brunch is good. I like brunch.
Johnson Family Brunch.
Yes.
I love brunch.
Is it like the full deal?
Oh yeah. So you've got ham, you've got eggs, you've
right.
got home fries,
I love
you've
that.
Got monkey bread.
Monkey bread.
Yeah, you know, you peel it apart. It's like that cinnamon sugar.
Oh, I never had monkey bread.
You would love it.
Mama monkey bread. I've never had monkey bread. Yeah.
Well, it looks like I'm gonna have to make some monkey bread.
Make some monkey bread for me.
Yeah, delicious though. So you've got like the sweet and the savory, and
now when you guys,
my father's birthday is actually this weekend, so we're gonna be celebrating that.
Happy birthday! Happy. Now, when you guys were little, would the Easter bunny leave eggs in the yard? Were there Easter egg hunts for you?
So we did something fun. We would dye Easter eggs, and we would each pick one egg in particular that we would leave in our Easter basket the night before.
Right.
And the Easter bunny would take that specific egg and hide it somewhere throughout the house.
Sure.
So that morning we'd have to look for our particular egg, and then there were also jelly beans scattered.
Got it.
So we'd collect all those, but sometimes there would be an egg hunt outside.
Nice, nice. We're gonna have probably about maybe 15 people over. With the girls, when my girls were little, we would always have Easter egg hunts around the house, around the yard, and they were filled with candy. Now they're a little older.
So the
Easter bunny has learned that in order to get them outside, you have to fill it with money.
Yep.
That's when the kids will, that's when they'll go out there and, fight over the eggs and see who gets what eggs.
Do you give them a certain color? Because we've done that when we've conducted certain egg hunts, you collect the green eggs, you collect purple.
That's probably the smart thing
that
to do.
That way it's fair, everyone gets the same amount of eggs.
No, at our house it's like a gladiator fight.
It's like a couple bitty passes outside
it's every kid for themselves. And we also, I also have a niece who's like 9 years old, and they don't want to like rough her up too much.
Right.
But, it is Easter. But there's cash in there, those eggs. So they kind of like try to help her out and make sure that, she gets some cash
as well as they
get cash.
Very sweet.
So
is there a meal or anything?
There is a meal.
There'll be
some ham made. And I got to say, the ham that we got at home, it's massive.
Well, you said 15 people are coming over, so.
Yeah, there's a lot of people.
I like leftover ham, too.
I like leftover. I'll give you ham if you give me monkey bread. Deal. There you go. Happy Easter.
Sharing is caring.
Sharing is caring.
Brendan, what do you enjoy on Easter?
I just feel like I'm witnessing a business transaction up there on the set. Well, when we were younger, we would have the egg hunt, my brother and I, and we would be fighting over those eggs. The true spirit of Easter on full display.
Yes.
Two brothers going at it over the eggs. This year, just some family stuff. Well, all week long, the Easter Bunny and I hopped around town asking people what their plans were.
Easter Bunny creeps me out,
that's,
by the way.
Yeah,
he had
does.
Time for that?
He did. In reality, I simply checked in on our social media pages to see what our friends are up to this weekend. Here is a small sampling of what they had to say. Lucky McLean is up first today with her plans, going to Sheep Pasture in Easton at 6 a.m. For a sunrise service.
Oh, that's nice.
Beautiful.
All churches take part. Very nice.
Oh, say a prayer for us.
For all of us. The bird leaves us. Mark Anthony Simonson continues quality family and friends time with more food than we could imagine.
Mm-hmm.
Take home plates for everyone.
Yeah, sounds good.
Very nice. Paul Stanley has an enjoyable Easter planned, time with the family, and nothing but laughs and fun. Very nice. And last but not least, the Prince of Fun himself. Adam Thoreau has a phenomenal Easter tradition. I make it well known that I strongly dislike peeps. So every year I get boxes of them from many different family members.
You know, it sounds like something my family would do.
In return, look at what he does. I send them pictures of me running the peeps over in my car or in a blender.
Oh, see? That is the Easter spirit.
Fun. A peep smoothie?
Yeah.
Fun stuff like that. Thanks, Adam.